And it came to pass in those days that there went out a decree from Caesar Augustus that all the world should be taxed. And all went to be taxed, every one into his own city. And Joseph traveled many days' journey with Mary, his espoused wife, being great with child. And so it was that while they were there, all alone and without family, in a hole dug in the ground, meant to keep animals, in the dirt, and without most of the basic essentials for life, a mother's days were accomplished that she should be delivered. And she brought forth her firstborn son, and with great joy and praising of God, she wrapped him in the best she could find, and laid him in the best there was available, because she was a mother, and there was no room for them in the inn. And his name was called Jesus. As you can see, today we are going to honor mothers on a very special Mother's Day. We have one more video for you. Our first hymn this morning is My Heart Will Go On.
Show you go on.
to our mothers who are with us today only in memory. Will you please bow with me? Dear most glorious and wonderful Heavenly Father, how wonderful it is to be here this beautiful and glorious morning, a time we come to give you praise for all that you have given us and done for us. You have blessed our lives with so much richness. One of the greatest of blessings is that you have given us godly mothers and wives. Where would we be without the love and guidance from our mothers? And where would they be without the special relationship that must exist between you and them? Thank you for the guidance we have received from you through our mothers' love and care. We thank you for our mothers and for all the struggles that they have endured on our behalf. There never comes a time when the job of motherhood is complete. For as long as mothers hold breath, they will be always mothers, praying, encouraging, motivating, scolding, pushing, and when none of that brings about the desired result, they will be back to you praying some more. We thank you for our mothers, and we especially ask you to continue to be close to them and to their prayers. Help us to be the people you desire us to be. Fill our hearts with love for one another, and teach us how to spread that love to all around us. Hear our song this morning and our praise, for it's in the name of our precious Lord and Savior Jesus Christ that we pray. Amen. Our responsive reading is from Scripture, Proverbs 31, 28 through 31. Her children rise up and call her blessed, her husband also, and he praiseth her. Favor is deceitful and beauty is vain, but a woman that feareth the Lord, she shall be praised. Amen. And bless the reading of God's word. So we have a couple of praise songs this morning. A lot of these are kids know, so come on kids, let's hear you sing this morning.
Deep and wide, deep and wide, deep and wide, there's a fountain flowing deep and wide. Wide and deep, wide and deep, there's a fountain flowing wide and deep. Wide and deep, wide and deep, the fountain flowing wide and deep. Deep and wide, there's a fountain flowing deep and wide. Deep and wide, deep and wide, there's a fountain flowing deep and wide. I know, for the Bible tells me so. Little ones to him belong, they are weak, but he is strong. Yes, Jesus loves me. Yes, Jesus loves me.
All right, we're going to move on to our memory verse. Our memory verse this month, Matthew 7:20. Wherefore by their fruits ye shall know them. Matthew 7:20.
Wherefore by their fruits ye shall know them. Matthew 7:20.
Amen. Good morning.
Good morning.
Good to see all of you this morning. And I know the kids are all doing their thing, and it's good to see everyone. It's good to see you at home watching us. I hope that you'll have a happy Mother's Day, and that we can bring you some joy and cheer in your life as well this morning. And we're thankful for you that you spend your time coming and being part of our program here. We're still having our Wednesday Bible study at 1 o'clock, and so we're glad to see everybody. We're having a good Bible study. We're in the book of Acts, and we've been having a good Bible study and a good turnout for that. Thursday afternoon, the kids program at 3 o'clock, and our program keeps growing and growing a little bit every week. Someone else is coming along, and so we're having a great time with that. Matter of fact, we had one of the dads come out the other day and on Thursday and took the kids out in the field and played baseball. And some of these kids can really hit the ball. So I was happy to see that. I was working on getting the rest of the backstop up, but soon I'll be out there playing with the kids, getting the ball up out there too. Next Sunday, we'll have potluck here at the church because we've gone to our schedule of having potluck every other Sunday. And the baseball field is coming along. I've got some fence. We've got the backstop, the posts up, and some of the fencing up around that and everything done on that. So we're working to get the rest of the fencing up. I'm hoping that that'll be done this week. And then I'm going to make a tool to help grade the ground out there. And then again, we're still talking about summer camp. We got everything set up. We got even another tent for kids this summer. And we're happy about that. I also want to make sure that you know that you can pick us up on Facebook. To see what we're doing here at the church. We're getting a lot of pics and people pulling up our Facebook page, and we're happy about that as well. You can write me at Reverend Babcock at P.O. Box 41, Titusville, 16354. You can write me at cbc.tville@yahoo.com if you want to. Here, one of the things I want to make sure you have is down here in the middle, www.oilregionlive.com. If you want to send, one of your friends or somebody that you know anywhere in the country how to get a hold of us or how to see this service, you just tell them to go to www.oilregionlive.com. That's all one word, lowercase, oilregionlive.com. And they can pick us up any place in the country, any place they can get internet. You can pick us up there. Just go to there and go to religious services and look for Community Bible Church. And then, again, we want to thank Armstrong Cable for and the stream for making this available to us. And if you want to call us out here to church, and the reason I'm going to make sure that you have the number for calling is that, you know, I'm here to do counseling, and I've been a professional counselor. I was that for many years. I worked for the court, for the juvenile court, for Catholic Charities. I did a lot of counseling all over, and so we're here. We never turn anybody away, and I want you to have that number, 967-3628, because I'm here to do marriage and family counseling or alcohol and drug counseling or whatever you may need. And I know that one of the things that when people come in to see me, they're always surprised that by the quality of the counseling, just because you might think that from that the counseling might not be that great, but I've got a lot of training and a lot of experience, and we do a fair amount. We'd like to do more counseling, and I know there's people out there that need family counseling and drug and alcohol counseling, and so please keep the number in mind. We never turn anybody away. We don't charge for counseling, and so if you need counseling, please give us a call. I also want to make sure that people know that that if you can write me and ask for prayer requests, you can make us your church. Let us know that you're a regular listener and watcher, and that you are making this your church. And I know that some of the churches have gone way down in population. One of the churches in Titusville used to, when I first came here, was in the 300s every Sunday, is down to few. I know that a lot of you are out there watching, and I know that some things have happened that I what's sad to me is a lot of the things that have happened around the country and around our communities and that have made people kind of bitter a little bit towards the church, and I think that happens when we get attached to a church instead of being attached to our Lord Jesus Christ. And we, that's where we need to be attached, not to the pastor, not to the church, not to the denomination, but to the Lord Jesus Christ. And that's why this memory verse is so important. Wherefore, by their fruits ye shall know them, because you can't sit at home and produce fruits. We've got to be working and working in a church to produce fruits, or working through a church. And I know that's difficult for some people, but there's always ways. Then you can give us a call and find out how you can be instrumental, how you can be involved, how you can still be effective. You know, we read in Revelations that God keeps us around so He can keep us busy, and so all of us that love our Lord Jesus Christ and love our God. Know that we have things to do, and that's a problem that I have with a lot of people in the churches that we've been studying about people in the churches that like Cornelius, that knew about God, but knew about Jesus Christ, but didn't know about Jesus Christ, and he came. Peter came to at the request of an angel from God, and he came and gave Cornelius and his whole household the story of Jesus Christ, and they believed. And so, and again, they did good works and did many things. So, we are trying to encourage people to come out. We have a whole group of kids. We need all kinds of help and assistance, and we're looking for anybody and everybody that wants to praise our Lord and work and help in the ministry. All right. Well, that said, how about praises this morning? I mean, it's a praise that we have our mothers here. Some of us have our mothers here or grandmothers here, and somebody has a Papa Sue here, and yeah, it's okay. I got a smile there, And so how about prayer? How about praises and prayer requests? We have praises this week. I know I'm thankful that my knees are holding up while I'm getting this work done. Now I'm still back on the ladders climbing up and down and doing some things. But I praise God for my ability to get those things done. Anyone else this morning have a praise? How about a prayer request? Yes. Pardon?
I think it'd be nice if we prayed for Canada for getting their fire out.
Yes, for the fire in Canada. In Alberta. And that some of the times when they have fires up there, I was up in Alaska one time when they had a fire in Alberta in about the same area, and the whole sky was, I mean, you couldn't breathe. I mean, we were hundreds of miles away, and still the sky was full of smoke. All right, anyone else this morning? Yes?
I think we ought to pray that we get some fire back in the bus.
Pardon?
Get some fire back in the bus.
Yeah, we need some prayer for our bus. To get it back going again, it'll run, but it won't stay running. So I think we've got a filter problem, and we'll get that taken care of. Because these days we can't get along without the bus. I mean, what a praise! We bought the bus. One of the first things that we did when we came out here, because that's what we wanted to do, was reach people, families, and kids here in the area. And now we've gotten to a point where we just cannot make it through the week without the bus, and that's really a praise. So, yeah, we'll pray for getting the bus back in order. Anyone else this morning? We want to pray for our country and for our moms and those that are still out sick. But most people are getting recovered from all of the sickness. So let's go to the Lord in prayer. Dear most gracious Heavenly Father, we thank you for watching over us. We thank you for giving us the opportunity to come boldly before the throne of grace. We thank you for all the things that you do for us each and every day, and all the things that we don't even know that you do for us, all of the mountains that you clear ahead of us, and the paths that you make straight and so that we can move, the deer that you move out of the way in front of our car that we don't even see. We ask you to continue to watch over us and help us to grow and help us to be all that we can be, to continue to spread the gospel of Jesus Christ through this community to all who will listen and all who will hear. Help us to learn how to remove the scales from people's ears and from people's eyes so that they can hear the true gospel. We ask you to be with this country as we continue to go through the election cycle, to be with us as we attempt and try and pray and want to be the country that we have always been, the Christian nation that is able to live a life as Christian people and think about the rest of the world as we minister all around the world as well. It's been difficult these last few years because the money that people have had that would go into the churches have dried up. So help us to return to the country that we need to be. We ask you to be with all of our police officers and firemen and all of those who provide service to this country. To be with the military as they watch over us, and their parents who are spending these days, especially today and other holidays, away from their children. We ask you to be with the people that are in Alberta, Canada, that are going through the fire, and those that are going to be suffering from the smoke that will go even a farther way. We ask you to watch over our bus and help us get that back in order. We thank you for our moms, Lord, and we know that none of us could be what we are without our moms. And we thank you for all the moms here at the church who are moms Sundays and moms Thursdays and moms lots of other days. We thank you for all that you do for us. We ask you to be with those that are sick and watch over them, help them to return to us. We ask you to be with the kids that are not here this morning, and many of them are with their moms this morning, and we just ask you to be with them as well. We ask all these things in the name of our precious Lord and Savior Jesus Christ, we pray. Amen. All right, kids, I'm going to ask you guys to come down here in front, and you're going to be with me this time. Uh-oh. Come on down. Yeah. All right. Now we tried to do better than we did last year. But did we do? But you're going to have to help me sing this song off of the Mother's Day screen, off of the screen. So you can turn a little bit.
Every day you kept me safe and warm and loved and fed. But today's your special day, it was my turn instead. So I got up at 5 a.m., I've been working hard since then. Some things I didn't get quite right, next year I'll try again. Just for you I did my best to cut my own hair. Some places came out pretty good and some are
came out bare.
I washed all your nicest clothes, but the washer wasn't free. So I used the dishwasher, pretty smart of me. Remember, no one's perfect. Every kid has faults. Remember, it's the thought that counts more than the results. My heart was in the right place, even though I did it wrong. It was all to say on Mother's Day, my love for you is strong.
Right?
I vacuumed really quietly, I didn't use the power. I cleaned your dirty iPad screen, I held it in the shower. I painted all the ceilings, it was easy with the mop. Now the carpet's painted too with cool rainbow drops. I answered all your work emails with just leave me alone. And we gave a prince from Scandinavia alone. I watered all the houseplants
with the garden hose.
I forgot to turn it off, sometimes that's how it goes. Remember, no one's perfect. Every kid has faults. Remember, it's the thought that counts more than the results. My heart was in the right place, even though I did it wrong. It was all to say on Mother's Day, my love for you is strong. Your car shiny inside and out with lots of olive oil. Who knew that oatmeal splatters up so high and far on boil? I tried to make you orange juice, but I spilled it on the floor. I tried to fry your bacon, we don't have a stove no more. Since you can't really cook this week, I called a pizza place. I emptied out the fridge and freezer so there's enough space. They should be here any time, 2 dozen pizza pies. I paid with your credit card, I hope that you're surprised. Remember, no one's perfect. Every kid has faults. Remember, it's the thought that counts more than the results. My heart was in the right place, even though I did it wrong. It was all to say on Mother's Day, my love for you is strong. My heart was in the right place, even though I did it wrong. It was all to say on Mother's Day, my love for you is strong. It was all to say on Mother's Day, my love for you is strong.
All right, now let's look out. I want you to look out to the camera and say, Happy Mother's Day to all your mothers. All right? One, two, on three. One, two, three. Happy Mother's Day. All right. Now, I've got a job for you guys. I want you to give a flower to all of the moms here, okay? So, Cain, you have to get down. You have to get down. Get down, Cain. All right, go give flowers. Look. All right, give a flower out to somebody. To moms. Give a flower out to a mom. Give a flower out to a mom. Give a flower out to a mom. Go give a flower out. Oh, okay, you want one too. Okay, go give a flower out. While you're giving out the rest of the flowers, we got one more. Go ahead, give it to Polly. All right. And then I've got one that you're going to take to your mom. And you've got one that you're going to take to your mom. And you've got one you're going to take to your mom.
Get him now, get him now, get him out of bed.
And you've got one
you're going to
take.
Come on. Sleepy head. Here's clothes,
you've got one you're
going
to take
to
your mom.
Get him now, get him and make your bed. Are you hot? Are you cold? Are you wearing that? Where's your books and your lunch and your homework? Yeah, grab your coat and your gloves and your scarf and hat. Don't forget, you got to feed the cat. Eat your breakfast, the experts tell us it's the most important meal of all. Take your vitamins so you can grow one day to be big and tall. Remember the orthodontist will be seeing you every Tuesday. Don't forget your piano lesson is this afternoon, so you must play.
Don't shovel too slowly, but hurry, the bus is here. Be careful, come back here. Did you wash behind your ear?
Play outside, don't play rough. Would you just play fair? Be polite, make a friend. Don't forget to share. Work it out, wait your turn, never take a dare. Get along, don't make me come down there. Clean your room, fold your clothes, put your stuff away. Make your bed, do it now, we don't have all day. Were you born in a barn? Would you like some hay? Could you eat? Hear a word I say.
Get off the phone. Don't sit so close. Turn it down. No texting at the table. No more computer time tonight. Your iPod, my iPod. If you're going to sit up, we're going with the moment. What time do you think you're coming home? Say thank you, please excuse me. Makes you welcome everywhere you roam. Appreciate my wisdom someday when you're older and you're grown. I can't wait till you have a couple little children of your own. But right now, I thank you not to roll your eyes at me.
Close your mouth when you chew, would appreciate. Take a bite, maybe two, of the stuff you hate. Use your fork, do not burp, or I'll set you straight. To eat the food, I put up on your plate.
Get an A, get the door, don't be smart with me. Get a grip, get in here, or I'll count to three. Get a job, get a life, get a PhD. Get a dose of I. Don't care who started it, you're grounded until you're 36. Get your story straight and tell the truth for once, for heaven's sake.
That's a church group out of, I think, out of Atlanta, but I just love that. A lot of people like that song, or that rendition. Our hymn, This Amazing Love.
You love me in a way that's not like any other. It must be a part of heaven's design. This amazing love, as arms that reach to hold me, as hands that shape and mold me and wipe away my tears. Feels like home to me.
We're going to do some reading from several different, from Exodus, Proverbs, Revelation, and Samuel. And there went a man of the house of Levi and took a wife, a daughter of Levi, and the woman conceived and bare a son. And when she saw him that he was a goodly child, she hid him 3 months. And when she could no longer hide him, she took for him an ark of bulrushes and daubed it with slime and with pitch, and put the child therein, and she laid it in the flags by the river's bank. And his sister stood afar off to wit what would be done with to him. And the daughter of Pharaoh came down to wash herself at the river, and her handmaidens walked along by the riverside. And when she saw the ark among the flags, she sent her maid to fetch it. And when she had opened it, she saw the child, and behold, the baby wept. And she had compassion on him and said, "This is one of the Hebrew children." Then said his sister to Pharaoh's daughter, "Shall I go and call to thee a nurse of the Hebrew women, that she may nurse the child for thee?" And Pharaoh's daughter said to her, "Go." And the maid went and called the child's mother. And Pharaoh's daughter said to her, "Take this child away and nurse it for me, and I will give thee thy wages." And the woman took the child and nursed it. From Proverbs we read, Proverbs 31, "Who can find a virtuous woman? For her price is far above rubies. The heart of her husband doth safely trust in her, so that he shall have no need of spoil. She will do him good and not evil all the days of her life. She seeketh wool and flax and worketh willingly with her hands. She is like the merchant ship. She bringeth her food from afar. She riseth also while it is yet night and giveth meat to her household and a portion to her maidens. She considereth a field and buyeth it. With the fruit of her hand she planteth a vineyard. She girdeth her loins with strength and strengtheneth her arms. She perceiveth that her merchandise is good. Her candle goes not out by night. She layeth her hands to the spindle, and her hands hold the distaff. She stretches out her hands to the poor. Yea, she reaches forth her hands to the needy. She is not afraid of the snow for her household, for all her household are clothed in scarlet. She maketh herself coverings of tapestry. Her clothing is silk and purple. Her husband is known in the gates when he sitteth among the elders of the land. She maketh fine linen and selleth it, and delivereth girdles unto the merchants. Strength and honor are her clothing, and she shall rejoice in time to come. She openeth her mouth with wisdom, and in her tongue is the law of kindness. She looketh well to the ways of her household, and eateth not the bread of idleness. Her children arise up and call her blessed, her husband also, and he praiseth her. Many daughters have done virtuously, but thou exaltest them all. Favor is deceitful, and beauty is vain. But a woman that feareth the Lord, she shall be praised. Give her of the fruit of her hands, and at her own works praise her in the gates." A mother's tribute. We just read in Revelations 12:17 about the things that will happen during the great tribulation period. "And the dragon was wroth with the woman and went to make war with the remnant of her seed, which kept the commandments of God and have the testimony of Jesus Christ." Satan is angry with women because a mother brought into the world Jesus Christ. Jesus Christ meeting the Messiah who would come to save the world, or at least everyone who will believe in him. We've seen the movie pictures about Jesus' mother. I think she must have been the picture of perfect motherhood. I bet she played with Jesus. I bet she tickled him when he was small. Maybe blew kisses on his belly, as we all probably have done on more than one occasion. I bet she made him share his toys with his brothers and sisters and eat his vegetables. Can you imagine that? That Jesus' mother maybe had to make Jesus eat his vegetables, just like your mom had to make you eat your vegetables too. I want to look at Samuel. Samuel 1, 9 through 15. So Hannah arose up after they had eaten in Shiloh and after they had drunk. And Eli the priest sat upon a seat by a post of the temple of the Lord. And she was in bitterness of soul and prayed unto the Lord and wept sore. And she vowed a vow and said, O Lord of hosts, if thou wilt indeed look on the affliction of thine handmaiden and remember me and not forget thine handmaiden, but will give unto thine handmaid a male child, then I will give him unto the Lord all the days of his life, and there shall no razor come upon his head. And it came to pass, as she continued praying before the Lord, that Eli marked her mouth. Now Hannah, she spake in her heart. Only her lips moved, but her voice was not heard. Therefore Eli thought she had been drunken. And Eli said to her, How long wilt thou be drunken? Put away thine wine from thee. And Hannah answered and said, No, my lord, I am a woman of a sorrowful spirit. I have drunk neither wine nor strong drink, but have poured out my soul before the Lord. Mothers often find themselves pouring out their soul before the Lord. She was tormented in her soul for a child not yet born. Being a good mother starts way before the baby is born. We know that a child that was born was named Samuel, and he was one of the greatest prophets of Israel. Moses' mother was a great mother, as we have read. She was willing to give her baby up to another instead of seeing him dead at the hands of Pharaoh's guards. The name Moses means drawer out, and Pharaoh's daughter named him this because she had him drawn out of the water. She could have been the sister or older daughter of Pharaoh. According to Egyptian custom of the day, her firstborn son had the right to the throne. Moses would have been the next Pharaoh had the Pharaoh not had another child. I know that there is much invested into this time as being the time of Ramses II, but the archaeological evidence really points to a period that this really happened 200 to 400 years before Ramses. Virtuous here means a woman of character, a woman of strength, a woman of real ability. When God made Eve to be a helpmate, he made the other half of Adam. Adam was only half a man until God made Eve and gave her to him. It is a shame that today all around us there is such an attack on the family and on motherhood. I can see the need for such an attack. Just look at the story of Mary and Jesus. Jesus' last instruction on earth was to be looking after the caring for his mother. A good mother is truly a blessing. She holds the future of the world literally in her grasp as she instructs and directs her children in the proper way to grow up. I wonder if that is not really what the problem is with our culture and our world today, the lack of direction by Christian mothers. Can you imagine a world without the instructions given by Christian mothers? Maybe that is the reason why there is such an attack on mothers and on motherhood, especially Christian mothers. I have a few quotes and poems that I'd like to read. A London editor submitted to Winston Churchill for his approval a list of all those who had been Churchill's teachers. But Churchill returned the list with this comment, "But you have omitted to mention the greatest of my teachers was my mother. I did not have my mother long, but she cast over me an influence which has lasted all my life. The good effects of her early training I can never lose. If it had not been for her appreciation and her faith in me at a critical time in my experience, I should never likely have become an inventor. I was always a careless boy, and with a mother of different mental caliber, I should have turned out badly. But her firmness, her sweetness, her goodness were potent powers to keep me in the right path. My mother was the making of me. The memory of her will always be a blessing to me. And that was Thomas Alva Edison. I remember blaming my mother for sending me to church on Sunday. On one occasion, the preacher had to send someone into the balcony to wake me up. I thought it was hard to have to work in the fields all week and then be obliged to go to church and hear a sermon I didn't understand. I thought I wouldn't go to church anymore when I got away from home, but I had got so in the habit of going that I couldn't stay away. After one or two Sundays back again to the house of God, I kept going. There I first found Christ, and I have often said since, Mother, I thank you for making me go to the house of God when I didn't want to go. That was Dwight L. Moody. Thomas Fessenden wrote this. You painted no Madonnas on chapel walls in Rome, but with a touch diviner you lived one in your home. You wrote no lofty poems that critics counted art, but with a nobler vision, you lived them in your heart. You craved no shapeless marble to some high soul design, but with a finer sculpture, you shaped this soul of mine. You built no great cathedrals that centuries applaud, but with a grace exquisite, your life cathedraled God. Had I the gift of Raphael or Michelangelo, oh, what a rare Madonna my mother's life would show. This is one the kids, I hope, will like, so listen up, guys. I think my mom is an alien. No, really, honestly, it's true. She says she has eyes in the back of her head. Well, that's a really huge clue. She may be telepathic as well. Because she always knows when we lie. And sometimes when she's in a terrible rush, she says that she'll just have to fly. I think she's probably has superpower with X-ray vision too. She says she does the work of 10 men each day and tells Dad, I can see right through you. I think her weakness is dirt and germs. She's always cleaning up after us, and she makes us wear clean undies everywhere just in case we might get hit by a bus. And when she tucks us up in bed at night, she uses her powers of hypnosis to make us feel like tired little sleepyheads. I think my mom is the mostest. Moms are special. There is no love like a mother's love, no stronger bond on earth. Like the precious bond that comes from God to a mother when she gives birth. A mother's love is forever strong, never changing for all time. And when her children need her most, a mother's love will shine. God bless these special mothers. God bless them, everyone. For all the tears and heartaches and for the special work they've done. When her days on earth are over, a mother's love lives on. Through many generations with God's blessing on each one. Be thankful for our mothers, for they love with a higher love from the power God has given and the strength from up above. Will you please turn to our screen as we sing our hymn of dedication this morning, Give Thanks.
Give thanks to the Holy One. Give thanks with a grateful heart. Give thanks to the Holy One. Give thanks because He's given Jesus Christ, His Son. Give thanks with a grateful heart. Give thanks to the Holy One. Give thanks because He's given Jesus Christ, His Son.
Usher, please come forward. Will you please rise? Praise God from whom all blessings flow. Praise Him all creatures here below. Praise Him above ye heavenly host. Praise Father, Son, and Holy Ghost. Amen. Dear most gracious Heavenly Father, we thank you for this day. We thank you for our mothers. We ask you to bless this offering and to bless each and every person. To bless not only the offering that's given, but the work that everyone puts into this church, to all of our children. We thank you so much for all that each and every person does. We ask you to continue to watch over us and help us to get all the things done that we need to get done here, to grow this church, to be the place it needs to be, to reach out to the community all around us. Help us to be everything we need to be. Help us to spread the gospel. Help us to be a beacon to this community. We ask you to be with our children and keep your hands upon them as they go about their school this week and all the things that they do. To keep your hands upon their parents especially, and upon those that are giving them instruction and guidance, that all the instruction and guidance that they receive will be a blessing to you. We ask you to continue to help us do all the work around here that we need to do to reach out to all the people that need to hear the gospel. We ask us, ask that you give each and every one of us the opportunity to invite someone to the Kid Fusion program, to Sunday school, to church. Give each person the opportunity to witness to someone by their life and by their word. Help us to bear fruit so that people all around us will know who we are by the fruit that we bear. We ask all these things in the name of our precious Lord and Savior Jesus Christ, we pray. Amen.
Amen.
Fast, strong, and true. No.
It's a beautiful day. Have a happy and wonderful Mother's Day. You may be dismissed.